My name is Mamogeti Pakeng, the Vice Chancellor of the University of Cape Town, and we are here today to celebrate UCT's first open access Sesotho book, authored by Dr Rethabile Possa-Mogoera. The launch of this book is significant because we as a university are on a transformation journey, on a decolonization journey. And it's one thing to talk about decolonization. It's one thing to say decolonize the curriculum and we're teaching African languages. But if we don't have publications coming out in those languages, it actually doesn't matter that we teach Sesotho. So it is important to see this kind of development in our African languages department because it says we are serious about decolonization, our decolonization project.
This book is very important in the history of UCT because it's one of its own kind. It has never happened before. And other than that, as African Languages Department, we want to intellectualize our indigenous languages and we want them to be incorporated in teaching and learning at higher education and including even lower. So this is a good start where we are saying we are here as the mother tongue speakers of indigenous languages and we are going to prove that our languages are strong, they have what it takes. Today I'm signing three copies. One is for the Vice Chancellor's personal collection. Another one is for UCT Libraries special collection that will be collected by Executive Director Ujala. And another one, it's mine.
This particular publication is of enormous significance to us at UCT Libraries as it represents the first open access book in Sesotho, which is one of the 11 official indigenous languages. Considering the dearth of materials in indigenous languages, this gives us the opportunity to look forward to greater collaborations with local writers and our academics in promoting literature, drama, whatever format or genre they may choose to write in so that we make it accessible to the local communities and South Africa and the world at large.
For us, we are saying not only do we teach African languages in an African language, but we are also contributing to that scholarship by publishing books. Even if they're going to be prescribed for children at basic education, they need to be reading books that are written by young black African women scholars in African languages.